A few weeks ago, I looked at an aluminum case made specifically for the Ampro 2. Well, today, I'll check out another Ampro 2 case, this one made out of wood. I was supposed to review it a while back, but it got delivered at work, and since I've worked from home for the last months now, it took me a while to actually pick up the package. But now it's here, and it's looking pretty nice, so let's check it out. So this case came in a black box, exactly the same as the aluminum case we looked at last time. It didn't come with a lot of foam padding, and the box was crushed a bit, but fortunately, the case was intact. The only other items included are 5 hex head mounting screws and an Allen key. The case weighs just over 200 grams, or half a pound, so it's very lightweight. The overall finish looks very nice, no rough edges, and the sanding is all even. There is a cutout at the back to accommodate a USB-C cable, and it's a decent size. Then there's a cutout for the on-off switch at the bottom, and a recessed section for the battery. It will fit the stock battery, but it wouldn't work for larger batteries. So my Ampro 2 already had the keycaps I wanted for this case swap installed, but I wanted to do a little cleaning job, so I went ahead and removed all keycaps anyway. This Ampro 2 has scale box wide switches, and initially came with a black case and matching keycaps. Using a small brush, I removed the dust and debris stuck on the plate. After that, with a Torx T5 screwdriver head, I unscrewed the 5 screws holding the plate and the PCB in place. This Ampro 2 had an upgraded 3000 mAh battery, but unfortunately it won't fit in that new wooden case, so we'll have to revert to the stock battery. The standoffs are just a tad too short to ensure we're not puncturing the battery with the switch solder joints. So I had to keep the battery out for now, given that I would have to resolder the connector to the original battery. I'll just do it later. I really wanted to try the case first. I first screwed it in, but it wobbled a bit, and then when fully screwed down, the USB connector wasn't aligned. So I knew something was wrong. You might have to play with the plate and case a bit to make sure it sits correctly, and then after a while, it was fine with the Type-C port dead center. Now to reinstalling the keycaps, these are PBT keycaps with an SA profile. They are made by ACCO and fairly affordable. The legends are die sublimated, so they should last a long time. I like the font and the overall look of these keycaps, and I think they fit well with a wooden case, giving a retro vibe. So here's a look at the overall result. The case looks very good and is even. I think it looks professional, and the quality is great for the price, given that it currently sells for around $60. Compared against the aluminum case I reviewed last time, the sides are much thicker and they are round compared to the sharp edges on the aluminum version. The angle is a bit more aggressive, but the overall height of the keyboard is higher, making this an overall very high keyboard, so it would benefit from a wrist rest. For now, I'll leave you with a sound comparison. So now to the battery installation. My battery connector on the PCB actually desoldered itself, not sure how. So not only I had to resolder the one attached to the battery, but also the one on the PCB. I don't have amazing soldering skills and I have a really cheap soldering iron, but I still managed to get it done. It's not perfectly straight, but it's somewhat holding strongly, so at least there's that. So back to the case, I was able to secure the stock battery in the recessed section and screw the PCB back into place. Overall, I would say the quality is better than equivalent GH60 wood cases I came across. The finish is similar to this cherry wood case I had laying around, but I used to own a walnut one and this one had chips and very little lacquer. It wasn't as nice as this one. Couple last things to note is that the cutout for the on-off switch is a bit too far away from the switch itself, so you almost need a tool to reach it. Another option would be to use a little jumper cap connector to make the switch longer, something that user OK3B suggested in the comments section of the aluminum case video. And funny thing is that the overall style of this build looks very similar to the Durgaard Fusion keyboard that I'm testing at the moment. A very interesting keyboard overall. Stay tuned for that review. So that wraps it up for today. Let me know what you think about this case down below. Would you consider getting it yourself for your own Ampro 2, and which keycap set would you pair it with? As always, I'll have an affiliate link to this case in the description, so feel free to use that link to help the channel at the same time, if that case interests you. So, thank you for watching, make sure to leave a like if you did, and don't forget to subscribe if you still haven't already, as I'll see you in the next video.